Ladies and gentlemen, it's my great pleasure to welcome you and to be among you today for the unveiling of the 2017 International DUBLIN Literary Award shortlist.
A time and an era where we're building walls, re-establishing borders, putting up boundaries. It's the one part of culture and society at the moment where ordinary people from all around the world can come together and break down those boundaries.
Well, the importance of the award is that it brings all of these excellent books from all over the world to readers in libraries all over the world.
As any other story, this one begins with the beginning.
This award celebrates excellence in world literature, so important stories written really well are important to tell the great themes of our time and of all times.
Confession of the Lioness by Mia Couto, translated from the original Portuguese by David Brookshaw, nominated by libraries in Brasilia, Brazil, and Oeiras, Portugal.
But somewhere within us there remains the memory of that far-off age. Illusions and certainties survive that have been passed on from one generation to another in our village of Culamani.
For Dublin, this is an absolutely fabulous occasion for us to showcase the city, to showcase our history, to showcase our heritage and our culture.
147 books. Mm. How did you get to the shortlist?
Through a lot of talk, through a lot of conversation. We have a great chair, Judge Sullivan, a federal court judge in the US, who really kept us on track. It's interesting how judges from all over the world would come to consensus on certain books. And there are some books we would pick up and we'd all say, yes, that is a great book.
Where he eloped with a village girl, a rather strange affair.
Excellence in world literature is the main criteria, so it doesn't disbar anybody because they haven't a big published canon.
Up over the Humpty Bridge, past the garage and into town.
In many cases, they were books that some of us hadn't encountered before. And that was the really exciting part of the process. There were books here that I discovered that I wouldn't have discovered before. And I think readers will discover that they wouldn't perhaps have encountered before as well.
For tourism, it really is bringing in an awful lot by again putting Dublin on the map there to try and showcase what we have the best to offer in Ireland. And we've so much history here with culture, with heritage, that this is really kind of the pinnacle of it. We're so proud of this award and people of Dublin are so proud of this award.